Hello and welcome to the Bread and Roses Community Kitchen. This is Michael, your host, and I just want to welcome you all to this space and thank you again for tuning in. So this week, our recipe, as always, is inspired by the local food hubs distributions here in Charlottesville, Virginia, and we're going to be making zucchini fritters. So for this recipe, you'll need two small zucchinis. I'm also adding some carrots to our recipe. As far as like seasonings, you'll need parsley. We have some fresh parsley here. We have some fresh oregano, also some garlic chives. And then we're also gonna add one beaten egg, a fourth cup of flour, a half cup of feta cheese, some salt, some pepper, some paprika, and some coconut oil to fry. And some other things that you'll need from your kitchen is a grater, two mixing bowls, a fork, a spatula, and a frying pan, and then you'll also need a knife and a cutting board. And so this recipe, again, is just a quick healthy snack that you can easily assemble. And some new things that we'll be talking about is just grating and squeezing our zucchini, which is something that you can also do with potatoes. I've tried this recipe with a yellow squash. It all works fine. And yeah, so if that's all, we'll just get started with the recipe. And so before starting, you always want to make sure that you give your vegetables a nice wash. The vegetables that I grabbed from the garden, again, just making sure you're giving them a nice wash. A lot of people use like vegetable scrubbers. If you don't have a vegetable scrubber, I just recommend really toughly rubbing your fingers against the vegetables that you're cooking just to make sure you get all of the dirt off of them. Like see here, for instance, our chives still have their roots. I'm just gonna cut those off, same with the carrot tops. And so how we're gonna start this is actually we're gonna grate our zucchini. And so what I like to do is just kind of cut off the ends, set those aside, making sure that your knife is pointed down, or like the top is pointed down. And then you just get your grater and you just grate them. Once you're done, you just want to transport it. So actually, before you transport it, what we're going to do is take one of your bowls and just put like a rag in it like this, and then put your zucchini on top of the rag. And so after this recipe, we're going to have to squeeze out the water. And this is just a way that I like to do it. You can use cheesecloth as well. If you don't have cheesecloth, I just recommend using just a rag. Either way will do. But you just, like, the idea is that you just want to squeeze as much water as you can out of the zucchini. And so yeah, zucchinis, they're really high in water content as well as in fiber. So those are just two really good benefits that you get out of them. And also they're very high in vitamin A and antioxidants. So just being cautious of that as you're making it. And so we're just going to grate the second one the same as we did the first one and then add it to our bowl. Set that aside. We're just gonna add that second batch to our bowl now. Make sure you just kind of pick up all your little scoops. Okay, and so what we're gonna do then is just get a little bit of salt and put it into the zucchini and kind of mix it around. We're gonna let that sit while we get our other ingredients prepared. Okay, and so next you wanna prepare your carrots that we're also gonna grate into our zucchini mixture. I'm just gonna cut off these beautiful carrot tops. And I recommend you keeping your carrot tops, like if you have carrots with their tops on. You can make a delicious pesto, and there's so many different ways that you can reuse the carrot tops. They have like a very yummy, spicy taste, kind of very, very spicy. I don't know how any other way to describe that. So we're just gonna grate these carrots too. And they're really small, so to the rag with our vegetables. We're just gonna let that sit right there. So just let that sit in the rag for a little bit. Push to the side. So then next, we're gonna cut our seasoning. So first I'm gonna start with the chives. I just kind of rip off the bottom half it, pick the roots, put it to the side, and then I'm just gonna cut this part. I also, if you'd want to put maybe, you could do minced garlic as well. It just kind of gives it a like flavor. Again, this is all comes down to flavor. When I was looking at the recipe, I saw that people had done Greek style and all different types of styles. So I encourage you to just kind of use whatever ingredients you have as far as seasoning. Okay, I'm just gonna go through that one more time. Gonna set these kind of extra ones up near the side, and so for these we're just gonna kind of keep them on the cutting board, and then we'll add them to the rest of everything after. So next you have some parsley. So with parsley, I kind of like to roll it up like this, or actually let me cut off the stems, and then I like to roll parsley up and then cut it. Be careful of your gloves. Okay. You kind of want to do it a couple times just so you don't have big chunks of parsley. It's best done minced really nicely. Okay. Set that over. chives. Okay, and then we're gonna take our fresh oregano. We're just gonna kind of take off the leaves. Smells delicious. Okay, set down the scraps. And then similar to the parsley, you're just gonna kind of like dice it. Okay, and once you have your spices cut, we're gonna return back to our zucchini and our carrots. And so this is a very crucial part in making the zucchini fritters and the reason why we put them in a rag. We're actually gonna try and squeeze out as much liquid as you can. So you just kind of get your rag that has them all wrapped and then you just squeeze them. Squeeze all of your excess water into the bowl. You just want to keep squeezing until you don't get any water. As you can see that a lot, I just recommend kind of settling it, wringing it, get as much liquid out as you can. It's very important that you squeeze as much out as you can. Once you like pretty much squeezed most of it out, you'll tell because when you're squeezing, not that much water is coming out. I'm gonna just keep on squeezing. And this Okay, and so I've squeezed out most of the water in here. And the reason why this is important is because you just wanna make sure that you have not a lot of water or it'll make like your zucchini fritters kind of hard to assemble. So once you have that squeezed, you're gonna grab your other bowl and dump that, all of those into that bowl. I'm just gonna clean up this area a little bit. Okay, and so once you have your zucchini and your carrots in a bowl, you're just gonna go ahead and add your seasonings, which I'm talking about the parsley and your chives and your oregano. You're gonna add the beaten egg. You're You're gonna add your flour. You're gonna add your cheese. We're gonna put a little bit of pepper in. A little pinch of salt again. Since you already added some salt, you don't really need to add more, but I'm just adding a teeny bit more. And then we're gonna add some paprika. And then you're just gonna mix that together until you create like a little dough. Okay, and once you've mixed it, we'll be ready to cook. And so you're gonna start by just heating up on medium some olive coconut oil. Just for a couple minutes. And I like to use coconut oil. You can also use olive oil for this recipe. Just making sure that you're using kind of a healthy fat. So what we're gonna do is I'm gonna use like a fourth spoon to just, and also if you guys would wanna see like the mixture, it's kind of clumping together, and that's what you want, like kind of like a doughy texture. And so what we're gonna do is just spoon a little cake together. And then just kind of set it up there. You want to cook them for about 3 to 5 minutes on each side, depending on how hot your oven is or how hot your oven heats up, you might keep it a little bit less on the more 3 minute side. This oven heats up a little bit more, so that's what we'll probably do. So I'm just gonna do a couple up there. Again, you just want to let them cook for about 3 to 5 minutes on each side. So you just kind of want to flip it when you get like a little brown crust. I'm gonna turn the heat down. Okay, and as they're finishing, you just wanna get a paper towel and set them aside to dry. And yeah, there are your zucchini fritters. We're just gonna sit here, flip these, put them on a napkin to be able to dry, and then go through and finish the rest of the dough. So today we made our zucchini fritters. Again, a very simple, easy recipe. It took no more than 20 minutes to prepare. And with just the recipe that I told you, I made about 10 fritters. They're pretty small, but again, they're really delicious. They kind of taste like pizza. So yeah, enjoy these, try different things. The yellow squash is really delicious with it. And the things that we are kind of focusing on, again, are just like easy to assemble snacks. Utilizing vegetables and just trying different things with our vegetables, and then also using techniques like the grating and the squeezing. Again, our recipe was inspired by local food hubs, and these cooking classes are brought to you by the Move2Health Coalition, thanks to the Sentara Starhill Wellness Center located in Charlottesville, Virginia. I welcome you all to send me your recipes, send me your ideas, send me different creations in which you've been inspired to do. And yeah, I'll see you guys next time. Thank you again for tuning in. Bye.